watched many years back, a man by the name of Sam Taylor, the blues man himself, brought Heather from New York. Her history of music is just incredible. And her love for God is even more. We're going to talk about amazing grace like never before. Let's bow our heads. Father, we ask you to take this time, man, just to open up our hearts. Let the word of God just be planted. And let this music just soothe our soul. Remind us of the words as we hear the tones and the sounds. Remind us of our amazing grace. Before we go any further, I want to read this to you, church. This is what we call the interactive sermon. You get the sermon part, you get one of these? Stuff that is bolded, underlined. Yeah, bolded, underlined, and italicized. Those are the church's words. Ready? Got it? When you read it, you gotta lean a little bit. Okay? You're there. And then we'll all get together on this. I just want to remind you, church, how grateful are you for God's grace? Now listen to this. We always start out with a psalm or something similar, but listen to this. This is, I want to set this for the foundation of the rest of the sermon. Verse 1, this is the full Psalm 15. This is the whole psalm. He didn't have to go into a long. He didn't have to use a lot of words to get his point across. Watch. He's talking about you, church. Who may worship in your sanctuary, Lord? Who may enter your presence on your holy hill? Those who lead blameless lives and do what is right, speaking the truth from sincere hearts. Those who refuse to gossip and harm their neighbors or speak evil of their friends. Remember how you used to be, church? Remember how you used to gossip? You used to criticize? You used to? Remember how you used to? Amen, church? You used to. No more, not now, but used to. Sometimes. That's not you anymore. You used to do this. You used to act like that. You used to say that. You used to. But no more.
But I try not to.
But God's amazing grace has freed you. It gives you permission to love. Those who lead blameless lives, that do what is right, speaking the truth from sincere heart. Verse 3 says, those who refuse to gossip or harm their neighbors or speak evil of their friends. Those who despise blatant sinners and honor the faithful followers of the Lord and keep their promises, even when it hurts, church. Who is he talking about? He's talking about you. You get to confess your sins. You get to be in the presence of God. You get to used to be like that. You get to now because you've called upon the name of Jesus. Yeah. And he's cleansed you. He's washed you. He's brought you into a place where none of that matters anymore. Yeah. You can learn about God now at such a young age that you can maneuver your life without falling into these traps that we've fallen in, to falling into these bad relationships and these things that we thought we were in charge of them. No! We gave it away to Satan. But then we ask Jesus to passionately forgive us as we passionately confess our sins. Verse 5 says, those who lend money without charging interest and who cannot be bribed to lie about the innocent. Church, this is such people. Such people will stand firm forever. Such people will stand together and worship God. We together feel and know God's amazing grace.
Yeah.
Miss Heather Harper, just listen. Just listen.
Heather and I met many, many years ago.
She was playing music, and I was playing a little music, because I was mostly bartending and mostly bouncing back then. So in between sets, we'd hang out. I'd hang out with the band, and we'd talk, and chucking out, became friends. And our daughters just became infatuated growing up. Alyssa and Jesse, Jesse actually played violin for a long time. Heather, let's go see Heather. And she just stayed such a close friend of mine. Just when I fell in love with God, she was just as surprised as anybody else. But we've been able to do some stuff together, play some music together. And what we've got to do is worship God together. That's the most important thing. And she asked to come here. She wanted to be here for you guys. She digs what we do. She's got a past, like we all do. And she knows that God has changed her life. She's here to share, to give back. John, just leave me. Pinch my ear or something. My ears don't want to hang no more like that. When you let your hair hang, or your ears hang.
They go back, look more short.
All these kids' songs. We got a buddy of ours in the town, he's got a little boy, and they have a TV watching this. Vocabulary. That's cool, man. Vocabulary. Yeah. I like Larry and Bob. Larry the cucumber and Bob the tomato. Bob, Bobby, Robert. Come on, man. We're on the cruise, we're like, hey, it's Bobby and Larry, where? Bobby Larry, come there. I'm not using this anymore, I quit. I ain't singing, so I don't need it.
Okay.
All right, church. Amazing grace, amen. Amazing. How the music just takes a good away. That's why God loved Lucifer so much. Because he was the angel of music, the angel of worship, man. He even liked him and hated him more than the other two. But don't tell him. He got all cocky. We know what happened then. But the music. God just loves music because music cuts through all the BS.
Amen.
Music cuts and then it plants itself. We love it. We go, I don't know, my God's got to fix this because we don't know what the hell is here. So we know that from here, God changes everything we do to get out here. Because what we do during the service is not how we practice. But when God takes over in his amazing grace and he's happy we're here. He's happy to join us. He's happy to be a part of this. God is happy. His amazing grace is the deal. It's the deal. It's what do you get out of this? What's the deal between me and God? All right, God, what do I get? If I give my life to you, what do I get? He said, amazing grace. What's this grace? What is this amazing? What is amazing? What is grace?
Undeserved.
Huh?
Undeserved forgiveness.
Undeserved. What else? God says, I'll wait a little longer for you. I'll wait a little longer. That grace period. You know when rent's due? And when you really pay rent?
Man, see?
You hear me, Chuck? I say, you know what rents do? And when you really pay, man, that's called the grace period. It used to be 4 days of that, just like, you know. God said, yeah, you're a sinner, man, beyond compared to anybody else. But you've given your life to me, so I wash away your sins and I call you sinner. When we do that holy of holies, I always think of Jesus laughing and like doing punching like this little knuckle punches, but you still see the wounds on his hand. They paid the price, you know? Just a little reminder, he's cool with it, you know, he's cool with it. But we can't be cool with it, you
can't let sin just keep going. We can't just keep acting the same way. We can't act the way we used to, because we're not like that anymore. We've got to start acting like you're going to heaven. You've got to start acting like you're somebody, because God has created you to be somebody. Amen. Amazing grace gives us peace, man. All of our lives, all we strive for, all we look for throughout our life is just a little peace. I wish that teacher would get off my back. I wish that coach would get off my back. I wish my mom and dad would get, you know, all through life, man. We're put into positions and places to be educated so that we can learn to be disciplined, so we can learn to obey, and we won't fall down the hole. But if we refuse to listen and refuse to learn, I should have listened. Duh. How many times have we come crawling back up? Next time I'm going to do something different. Amen? Maybe. Hopefully. But God says, my grace gives you a chance to do something different. I cover you for this one. It's over with. No one's going to try it again. Let's get it right. Watch. Look what Titus what it says, man. Check this out. First, it says, you know what? It says, to remind the move of the believers. Right now, it's in my mind. You are the church. You are the sober brother. Remind the believers to submit to the government. We're right in the middle of an election year. We see all this craziness going on. Instead of worrying about it, instead of getting all upset about it, just hand it over to God. Because, to tell you the truth, God's going to put into office who God wants for His glory. They let us think we get to vote. I don't care about no voting. Go ahead and vote. God gets His way because God knows what's going to happen. So we trust. You can argue. You can do all that politics all day long until the day after the elections. Then it's your responsibility, Christian, to pray for whoever God puts into any office, from Pima County Board to the city to the mayor, the governor, the Senate, straight to the presidency. Whoever God puts in there, you pray for. Clap even a little bit after that. That is another big political announcement. Beyond, remind the believers to submit themselves to the government and it. They should be. All of our lives, our family, our parents, our teachers, and God Himself is teaching us, trying to teach us to be obedient. And human being, you stubborn human beings. Oh, we are blessed to have grace.